I always knew that one day playing Factorio is gonna pay off. Hi guys, it's Neodyinamite and welcome to Factory Town. Now, this is a little tiny game that I spotted some time ago. The developer was very kind to provide me with a key for it, so thank you very much. Basically, if you haven't thought about this game, this is honestly a cute little game about building, let's say, a city, but also a factory. So imagine that you combine, let's say, Factorio alongside with Kingdoms and Castles. You probably remember that game that we have played on the channel, because more or less this is what this thing is. It also reminds me a little bit of the other game called The Colonists. So basically you build a town with actual factories and then you need to supply your citizens with certain goods in order for them to expand. Get the idea? Sounds simple. So let me actually try to pick up a decent map for us to play on. So you have actually like a bunch of things to pick up from. So there's like, for example, mountain lakes, plateaus, archipelago, volcanic island, flat, empty, craters, desert cliffs, foothill canyons, grand canyons, high foothills, high ridges, islands, lakeland, and swamp forest. So each one of those map is completely different. I think we could actually try to play. I want to play on something flat, you know, so that we're gonna have like a lot of space to build, and actually we can go a little bit crazy with learning the basics of the game. But also I would love to have like a river or something to build over. So maybe we're gonna go with I think I'm gonna just go with the first option because we have rivers, we have like a bunch of flat space, so that should be nice. Then you can actually pick biomes, so you have like a lot of things to choose from: plains and rivers, mountain lakes, plateaus, archipelago, volcanic island, flat, empty, and so on and so on. So let's maybe try to get to like a volcanic island just to add a little bit of space. Map size, of course, large. You can go with infinite if you really want to. Creative mode for now off. Auto balance, auto play space, let's set it on. Smoothing starting area, yes please, and starting state by default. So without further ado, boys, welcome to Factory Town. Just please remember, ladies and gentlemen, that the footage that you're about to see comes from the early access version of the game. As always, I'll leave you a link in the description below where you can get the game on Steam and other links if I'm gonna find any. For now though, let's actually try to make a good use of the map that we currently have over here. And apparently I can buy additional lands over here, just like in City Skylines, which is kind of interesting. I kind of like wonder what's gonna happen if I will get to the border of it. Will it expand further away? That'd be cool, because technically we can keep going and going and going and going towards the abyss and victory and glory and fun. So we're starting with a little base thing over here. Just so you know, I went through the tutorial, so more or less I have an idea what I need to do. Those guys are your workers, and you're gonna use them for now to collect a bunch of resources. So let's try to focus on getting some wood over here, because we need to have some basic, like, why are you not working? Ah, there you go. Because we need to set up like some basic building and production facilities. So for now, let's focus on mainly wood. And also I'm gonna order this guy to focus on the berries, so he'll be able to soon provide our houses a little bit of food. So now, since we have like the basic resources income established, let's try to plan where we're gonna try to build our settlement. And I think this area over here looks flat enough for me to actually make a good use of it. So let's make like two houses over here. With it we'll be able to recruit more people. Those are the herbs, so we can try to use that thing for something else later on. So at the moment we have the possibility to have 8 people in total, 4 currently working, an additional 2 per house over here. You can later on, of course, upgrade the houses for them to provide you with more people. So let's do this thing, for example. All right. So now we're gonna try to get some grain as well. So I'm gonna send my workers over here. Send one more guy over here and send another guy to the trees. There you go. Beautiful. Now the thing is, the food is used by the houses. So basically you put food inside, you get gold back, right? Basically the houses buy resources from you. At the moment you have to like make the workers so they'll deliver the resources to the houses, but later on you'll be able to make yourself like a market, and the market will be able to supply the people around with various resources. So it's like a little bit of banishment as well over here. But in my I think, in my opinion, this is more of like, as I said, Factorio actually, and kingdoms and castles. Right, so we got this thing ready. Look at them. And they're working. They are jumping jolly good just to get to work and back from work because mommy and the wife is waiting with hot ball of cooked grain. I'm not making enough food apparently for this thing to happen. Right. Let's try to make also some paths over here just to increase the speed of our little workers because that's like apparently the thing. Like a normal thing, right? I don't get it how you work a little bit faster on a made out of dirt path comparing to flat ground with just grass, but apparently that's the thing in a game like this as well, and they walk now faster, which is glorious. Now boys, it's actually time to get some proper manufacturing and resources, you know. It's time for the capitalism to hit this beautiful island, for we will soon need power. And no, there's no military in this game. So now what, you may ask? Well, now I need to find out the building menu. And another thing, according to this thing over here, is that we need to gather stone. So, yeah, all of this map, all of this thing is like resources, right? So we have coal over here, iron over here, stone over here, more coal, sugar, trees, tomatoes, grain, more trees, some herbs over here, coal, elf stone. I have no idea what that thing is. Some carrots, probably the elf stone. I use it to make some type of dark magic. No, maybe magic is involved. Maybe this is actually like a steampunkish scenario where magic will collide with technology of steam and everything will go to shit because of that. I don't know. We're gonna find out probably very soon. For now, I need to gather some stone. So, I'm gonna recruit two people and I'm gonna send them to get me some stone. In the meantime, we need to build ourselves a lumber yard. So, is that even a possibility? No, because we require stone at the moment, which is great, which is superb. So, I also need a free worker who will be gonna be working at the lumber mill. So that's like a thing. I kinda like wonder, can I make like more paths around this place? I could, but because of the grain, the paths will look really bad. So for now, I'm gonna try to avoid doing that thing. What we can do, however, is that we can try to prepare for the soon-to-be lumber yard. So, there it is. Okay, beautiful. I was looking for a button to actually remove some buildings. There you go. This looks so nice. So nice indeed. At long last, my trustful slaves. I mean, parts of the society. Important parts of the society. They've brought me finally some stone, which you could now use to make myself a wonderful, wonderful lumberyard mill, whatever thing over here. So why cannot build you? Oh, there you go. Okay. So build this thing here. And now new things become unlocked. We can now make crates, grain mill, workshop, cuddle, scaffold ramp, scaffold block, wood arc, wood bridge, wood pillar scaffold, and wooden bench. I have no idea what the wooden bench is. Don't ask me questions. So, set up the lumber mill to make me planks. As such, now be sure to assign somebody from your free worker space that's gonna be putting inside certain item, and then I put another guy who's gonna take out certain item, because this is something you need to actually do manually, otherwise the lumber mill will flood with resources and you won't be able to get anything in return. So that's how it works. Now we're getting planks, beautiful, beautiful planks, and we're gonna use those planks to upgrade our houses, and that's exactly what we're gonna do, because now we select the house, we click the upgrade house. And now, what's gonna happen is the house won't change its appearance, but we're gonna finally try to put some furniture inside, because that place was basically full of air and nothing else. Your base can be upgraded to increase the house limit as well. Oh yeah, I kinda forgot about that. So we need to get more stone. We need to look for like a stone deposit first. So I made myself a little tiny bridge over here, because apparently those stone deposits actually allow my citizens to, well, workers and trustful slaves, to unlock their pockets of stone. And they are, trust me, they are transporting boulders right now, you know? You may think that those things are their balls. No, 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 no. Those are just the rocks. All of them actually don't have any balls. You may ask why? Well, I have no bloody idea. So, we're getting some stone out of those guys, which is very nice. Kidney stones, actually, whatever, I think. So, we need to have at the moment 20 stone in order to upgrade the base. In the meantime, I'm gonna actually like try to show you the buildings that we can have. So, in the building section we have the market, general store, apothecary, specialty goods, school, stone mansion, pasture, forester, farm, forge, kitchen, machine shop, mine, steam generator, told you, a well, silo, barn, packager, magic forge, elemental raffinery, mana transmitter, mana receiver, recharger, enchanter, mana reactor, void obelisk, gigantic statue of my dick, fire shrine, water shrine, and earth shrine. Then you have the things for the workers, such as the wagon, the minecart, the harvester drill, and the fishing boat. Then you have for the paths, and trust me, conveyor belts are like a thing. Magic conveyor belt? Hell, you thought Factorio was clever! Check this out. Then you have other structures, such as like the bridge, stone bridge, stone wall, and other things I cannot unlock currently because apparently I'm a slacker. Then you have things related to moving the train around, and then you have, of course, the decor, so you can actually make your city slash factory slash China a lot more pleasing for the eye. And at long last, we have enough resources to upgrade the base, so let us upgrade this thing, and now our limit of housing have been increased as well, because we can build a food market, and the food market will be an important thing because it will allow us to focus on other things, and the houses will be able to get food on their own. Also, I need once again some stone, so if somebody would be kind enough and actually provide me with stone, that'd be really nice. Just saying. So with a little bit of time and effort and me basically staring at my population with such a way that they decided to fear and piss themselves, I got enough stone to build myself a market over here. And the market will be a very important thing for the next part of my brilliant, brilliant plan of dominating the planet. What? Did you know that we're gonna dominate the entirety of the thing? Well, now you know. And the more you know, the heavier you should be. So I'm gonna actually connect this thing really nice. Gonna make like this thing more decorative as such. And now the houses, if they need, they'll just collect the food from the market without the workers going there manually, which is very, very pleasing for the IB. Now, what else we have to make? We have to make grain mills that can turn grain into flour. That sounds really nice. That sounds really quick. So I'm gonna build this thing on the top of the hill. As soon as I'm gonna get, I have the resources. Why cannot build this thing? Oh, I don't have enough people. Okay, so can I upgrade a house that's gonna increase my population limit? I can. Delightful. So now let us do this thing again, and I'm gonna build you richly on the top of the hill over here. So sweet. Now select the recipe. Select flour from the grain, and now you need to set up a worker that was gonna work tirelessly and bring me the necessary resources. So first bring grain into the mill, then we need to find a slave, I mean an important part of the society, that we're gonna transport the freshly grinded grain into the market for the citizens to use for making lovely, fresh, tasty. My bots are ready together. Bread. Ah, I can smell it over here. But you can't force your workers to do everything manually, right? At some point, you need to make this thing more automated. This is where actually the cards come to play. The cards will greatly improve the amount of resources the villager can carry around. So first, we need to get some wheels. In order to get the wheels, we need to have a workshop. In order to build a workshop, I need to go back again to the crafting menu. And now I need to find a nice little place where I can actually build this thing. Why I cannot build it here? I can build it here. So let's build the workshop in the city, just to make this thing look more natural for the time being. Now select the recipes and let's select the wheel. Now if I understand this thing correctly, at the moment I need to have 4 wheels. Is there like a way to force my villagers only to make me 4 wheels? There are also other things. Cloth, books, shirts, cloaks, warm coats, reinforced plank, shoes, wooden axe, pickaxes, and bandages. Don't question me why I need bandages, man. Probably because somebody's gonna bleed. Probably somebody who's gonna not be paying the taxes on time. And now comes the part for finally automating a little settlement, because now we have access to make wagons. Oh yeah, man. And the wagons I have no idea how they work. Crutches are handy ways to transport goods from long distances. Note that only some items, mostly natural resources, will roll down chutes. Chutes? This is how you pronounce this thing? I have no idea. Also, you may need to rotate pieces to ensure that rolled items travel in the correct direction when they reach an intersection. Okay. So why the heck I built the wagon in the first place? I can transport the resources with the wagon. Okay, so how about we're gonna grab this thing from the grain mill, and you're gonna transport those resources to the food market, because apparently that's a problem over here. There you go. Okay, so the workers are no longer needed to transport the flour to the houses. You can actually focus on something else. So how about you're gonna focus on getting more grain to the mill. Look at it. You are not dropping this thing where you're supposed to drop it. Okay. Splendid. 4 houses supplied at the same time. Now, because in the future there's gonna be like a ramp over here, right? Like a path. So we're gonna try to put an elevated so that the resources will go above the path. And I kind of hope this thing will work. So, structure blocks. Okay, arc. This is the next thing I kind of like need. But will the... Okay, this thing won't work, actually, because I need to have, like, a higher thingy. Ah, we need this thing. Okay, so I would love to make the path here. Okay, something like that. So, can I make, actually, this thing over here? Okay, that's actually a good question. How this thing works? Hold on a second. Let's make this thing here and this thing here. Okay. Now, this thing needs to rotate here. You're not working the way you're supposed to work. Hold on a second. Do I have to build something on you? Arc? Okay, this is way too high, I think. But let's try to. Maybe this is the... Okay, that won't work, that's for sure. So looks like we have to build one more ramp. So how I can actually delete this thing? With this? Okay, that kind of works. So let's try this thing again, shall we? Maybe I need to build like a little wooden bridge? I have no idea. So I think I need one more ramp, but this could actually not work. But let's try it anyway. So you have to get connected. Ah, you can only go down or... up. You cannot actually turn. Okay, that's gonna be a bit problematic here. How I could try to solve this issue? I have to move the entirety of the thing to the side, isn't it? Just like that. Well, that's kind of sad, but apparently we have to do this thing like this. All right, that should be possible. So cancel this structures. Let's see, I need this thing, and then this thing, and this thing, and this thing goes here. Okay, so now you also need ramps. So, ramps can go here, and here, and then here. Okay, that should work. So let's see. I think I have to extend this thing one more time. Oh, what the shit I just did? Oh no, how to exit this? No, oh thank God. I was a little bit scary over there. Okay, we need to add one more of this. There you go. Now it actually is gonna work. Okay, rotate this. Like such. Okay, beautiful. And why you not want to get connected? The shit man? Oh. Okay, probably because this guy is walking over here. There you go. Alright, now it's connected, so... How do I force this thing to get used to? Left click on a tree or grain tile and drag the icon to the end of the Okay, so what? You want to tell me that? Left click on a tree or grain tile and drag the icon to the end of the Okay, so can I do the same thing with the wheel? I don't think so. Notification. Only certain items can be put it on this thing. Oh, so I cannot put wheels on this thing. Oh, shit. Okay, so let's maybe try to do flour. Can you just, excuse me, my good sir, can you actually grab a flower over here and put it on the thingy? I want you to put it on the thingy. Maybe I can't because I turned this thing towards the building. Okay, let's try to make it empty. Okay, that won't work. So I'll drop this thing back actually. Come on, drop it. I said drop it. Where are you going with that thing? Go back, you idiot. Oh, wait, I think I got this thing. So you have to grab the grain and then you put it on this thing, I believe. Right? This is how it's gonna work? So you're gonna harvest the grain. Okay, he's coming, he's coming, he's coming. Where he's coming? Okay, he passed at the mill. Well, it didn't work exactly the way it's supposed to work, but we got it on the thing. Great. The stone mansion will turn stone into stone bricks. That can be used to for advanced building and roads. Which allowed wagons to travel much faster. Yeah, let me just first fix this thing, okay? God damn it, mistakes have been made. Whoops. Ah, shit. The plan was there. The execution, though, was terrible. So let's just try to automate the brick production, okay? So, I've made like a path thingy to the stone mansion there. So, I want you to grab the stone and put it over here. I want you to grab the stone and put it over here. You, I want you to make this thing. Okay, that actually works. This is so nice. Okay, you're gonna do the same and you're gonna do the same. Come on, boys. Hell yeah. Manufacturing, man, like this is... This is great. Look at all of the time we've just saved because of this. Okay, this is actually very impressive if you think about that. Look at it. This stone is just traveling over there. That's so nice. That's really, really nice, man. Okay, so we're getting the bricks. So now what? Your base can be upgraded further to increase the house limit. Okay, what do you want me to get? I need wheels. Just as I thought. New buildings unlock, max housing by 4, school and general store. Okay, so now what we can try to do with this thing? General store can automatically sell planks, stone bricks and other utility items to nearby houses, just like the food market sells food. Okay, do I really want them to buy my utility items? Because I kind of like have a big use for that thing right now. Okay, we just need some bricks. Alright, so I decided another car thingy to deliver the bricks from the stone mansion to the base. Question is, how I can make a mine? Because I really would like to establish like a like never-ending supply of resources, you know, for the future noticed. There has to be like a way to do that thing. About that thing, I'm certain. I just don't know how yet. Well, when does the mine unlock actually? Requires mining. Yeah, we don't say, really? The mine requires mining from you. Would you look at that? I would never expect that thing to happen, actually. Okay, whatever. Make the general store over here. As such. And... okay, I think that should be enough for now. Right. Something like this. What else? Earn red coin. Different types of goods earn different currencies, which you will need to research and specialize building. Click the economy tab. The economy tab? Oh! Oh, would you look at that! I was like wondering why the hell I have different types of coins over here. So, the food provides you with the yellow coins, like the normal coins. And then, for example... stone bricks provide you with the red one. Iron plates provide you with the blue one. Clothing provide you with the blue one and red one, depending. Holy shit, there's a lot of things to do over here. My god! Okay, so my first delivery of stone bricks is coming here. I got red. I got red coins, oh my god. A school will lead you to research many new buildings and useful technologies. I thought this school is supposed to be a torture chamber for the young guanks. Nobody told me that there's like actually research going on inside. Holy shit, maybe I would actually pay more attention while I was there. Okay, so where I can build this thing? Let's try to build you here. Here? Here. Is a good idea? Maybe it's a terrible idea. Can I build you here? New recipe, paper. Okay. Alright, this looks a little bit weird. You know what? Let's actually try to decorate this thing a little tiny bit just to make it look more pleasing for the eye. So, road ramp. Like this. And I would like to have... What is that thing? Stone wall, stone bridge. I think we have to go with the stone bridge. Beautiful! Truly, truly majestic. Okay. So how do you do this thing? Speed. Select recipe. Farming. Ah! Forestry. Ah! Tree planter. Metallurgy. Forge. Railways. Machinery. Boat building. Enchanting. Okay, where's the mine? Farmer. Animal pasture. Medicine. Okay, let's go with the farming for now. Or do you have a different objective for me? The lumber mill can now produce paper. This recipe requires water. You can tell a worker to bring water or place a new lumber mill next to water to automatically supply it. Really? So let's actually try to moderate this thing a little bit. So destroy the lumber mill. I cannot. Why can't I destroy this thing? Okay, maybe I have to take out the resources from this thing. Okay, delete this thing, I guess. Right, will it not work if I'm gonna try to destroy you? I can't. Incapable target. Excuse me, how I can destroy this? This? Never mind, found the button. Okay, wonderful. Right, so let's put this thing next to the water. Like such. Okay, so now we should be able to make paper in this thing, right? According to the game guide thingy. However, I also want to automate this thing a little tiny bit. So, let's see. Wooden arc. Okay, something like this. It's exactly not the way I wanted to go. Is it like a different building to do this thing? Oh, wait. I know which one I could try to use. I could use wood pillars. Okay, there you go. That actually works. So, this thing goes here, then here, then here. Okay, that should kind of work, right? So, now I have to just delete this one. And now... Okay, can I... Okay, I cannot build it exactly the way I wanted to build. I just need to get this thing again. Like this. There you go. Now, grab those things. Just be sure to rotate it the way you want to. Okay. That kind of works, I believe. Looks a little bit weird, but okay, whatever. So, I want you to make... Let's see, can I order you to make paper? I think I can. Alright, grab the villager. I want you to supply this thing with logs. Okay. Now, how I can actually put this thing on the conveyor belt or whatever this thing is? There has to be a button to do that thing, isn't it? I just don't know how. Turns out I cannot transfer paper or planks using this system. Yeah, there goes my dream of automation in the village. There goes my dreams, scattered across the rocks, just like water. Oh well, man, apparently you cannot get everything you want in your life. Sad. But okay, whatever, I can deliver the paper manually to the school. If you can't help me, game, then do it on my own terms. So basically, this is how it works, right? I've set up a wagon to deliver paper from the lumber mill to the school, right? So now I'm using the red coins as well as some paper and a little bit of time, and we produce, like, let's put it this way, knowledge points, okay? So at the moment, the school managed to produce 10 knowledge points, and I need 25 knowledge points in order to unlock myself the farming. So, okay, that's actually not that hard. I thought it was gonna be harder. And I kinda plan to establish like a farming community because, you know, sooner or later I'm gonna run out of grain. So the idea here would be to set up the grain so that it's gonna fall into the grain mill, and after that we'll be able to supply the houses with more efficiency. Because right now this thing is barely getting supplied. They are getting the food they need, but not in an amount I would love them to have. So that's like kind of the thing. But yeah, this is one way to do it. And research, done. New building unlocked, farm. Animal pasture, new research available, medicine. Farms will automatically harvest nearby resources and replant them when depleted. Okay, so you want me to... Do I have to build this thing like literally next to the existing grains, or can I do this thing like in the open field and just hope for the best? Farm tile. Okay, how does this thing work? Alright, I want you to get grain, and I can a bunch of other resources here as well. Okay, that's interesting. So how do we get farming? Well, workers. Ah, farming. Okay. Farming tile. I need fertilizer. How do I make a fertilizer? That's a good question. How do I make a fertilizer in the god's name? Ooh. Hold on a second. Do I have this thing somewhere in my thingies? No. Not here, that's for sure. Maybe in the workshop. Nope. Okay, this is gonna become a problem. How do I make fertilizers? Ah, there you go. Processed by pasture. Use it to make farm tiles. Okay, so I need to have pastures first. Okay. Do I have even that thing over here? Don't think so. Hold on a second. Can you do this thing on the farm? No, I can't. Wait, do I have to... I don't think you have this thing to unlock, do you? Ah, okay, I actually need to unlock the animal pastures. Okay, and now this is kind of interesting because the pasture... I finally managed to get the pasture. The pasture requires... animal feed from the grain mill to produce fertilizers, or more of that thing to produce other things. So, for example, I can get wool, which is sellable as clothing, and that's gonna provide me with red coins. Meat, red coins. Leather is used for something else. Meat is just more red coins. And milk is apparently yellow coins. So that's kind of like a lot of things. Okay, so let's try to... Okay, leather? Okay, let's try to get beef, for example. And see how that's gonna work. However, now I'm gonna require a new grain mill, and we need to get more grain as well. Okay, that's gonna be a little bit more shitty. So what did I did in order to improve the production thingy? First, I've made like a crate over here next to the grain field. So the people go over here are gonna capture the resources and put it into the crate. A wagon will now go and grab the grain and put it inside this grain mill over here. And now this cart is gonna grab the ones from here and drop it to this house here. Okay. So that's one thing. Also, I need to have a well. And we need to send the resources to that thing. Okay, so this worker over here is transporting bricks, which I kind of like, don't like. So I'm gonna order him to transport me the animal feed to this thing. Right? So that should work. Okay, what the heck this cat is doing? Dude, this shit, why are you like riding around? Don't you have better things to do? Honestly, what the hell? Okay, we need to wait for the crate, for the wagon to actually like stand here. Wait, can I block this thing? I think there's like a way to block this thing, right? Hold on a second, decoration. Fences. Ah, crap, I need logs. I don't have any logs. No! Oh, okay, maybe he now find out what exactly require from him. Yeah, well, technically that's the thing I require from you. Okay, so that works. Now, this thing receives the animal feed, and now you need to get water. Okay, water, you say. Right, so that's gonna be a problem. Let's see. This worker is currently transporting logs, right? Okay, so I'm gonna for now give you a different task. So you're gonna grab and deliver the water. So we have to go to the river, grab the water from there, and then drop it next to the pasture. Just like that. Beautiful. Haha! Animal feed, here we come! And after a while, you get all the resources need, and now we're gonna produce me beef, along with the fertilizer, which I really need. So how much fertilizer I have in the base? At the moment, 2. Okay, so now, the new plan is, wreck this farm over here. Okay, because we have a lot of space over here, up the hill. And that means, wait, can actually grain get transported by this thing? I think I can transport grain here, right? Let's see. How I can actually see what type of resources I can transport here? Okay, let's try to transport, I guess, paper and put it on this thing. Okay. Yeah, I can transport grain on this thing. Okay. I can also transport cotton and eggs and animal feed and flour. Okay. So, in other words, I'm gonna build a farm up here. Like this. Okay. We're gonna make even like a nice little path thingy, whatever thing. I cannot make this path. Why? Cannot afford it. Oh, I don't have wood. Oh, okay. That's a problem. Okay, so now I should actually be able to make the farming, right? So let's see how the farming will go. Okay. So I got the farming. So now what? Select recipe. Grain. Okay, so why not working? You require fertilizers? What? I need to put a worker here? That's actually a good question, because I have no idea how to enable that thing to work. Okay, I have a worker over here. Get over here, man. Come on. We need to experiment with the fields. No crop planted. Use the building farming tool to place a crop. Build. Farming. Ah, plant grain. Interesting. Okay, so how does thing grows? Ah, it just grows. It does not exactly require anything. Using the many recipes also helps speed up growth. Oh! Okay, so if I'm gonna build a well over here... I can't because I don't have bricks. God damn it. Okay, so he's now just putting the water inside of the farmhouse. And apparently that thing is working. Which, look at that! Wait, can I somehow transport water just to this thing? Can I actually like make a pump or something to transport the water easier to the farmhouse? Because that'd be really impressive. Hold on a minute. There has to be like a way to do that thing, right? Not this thing. Let's see, where's the well? You have an output dot from I can see. Okay, let's hold on a second. Put this worker here for now. Delete this thing. Delete this thing underneath you. Okay, now, let's see. If I'm gonna put buildings, well, like this. Okay, this thing is at the moment full of water, so I cannot do anything. And we got a bunch of grain! Holy shit! Okay, so now... Oh, this wagon is stuck. Guys, come on, what the fuck, man? Allow the... There you go. Okay, that's nice to know. Okay, so can I get rid of this worker? I can. Okay, that's nice. He decided to commit a suicide. For the glory of the community, I guess. Make a wagon. Okay, let's try to grab all of the grain and go with this thing somewhere. Bye! Okay, so are you getting supplied with water right now? I don't see, you know? Hard to say. But technically, if I understand this thing correctly, the water is getting dropped directly into the farm. And that's the thing I wanted to achieve here. Okay, water's getting applied. Okay, I don't think the water is getting used right now. Alright, so let's see. Can you actually like tell me again what I can put here? Will this thing actually work the way I want it to work? Research? No, that's not the thing I need. Where do you... Like, I need better instructions in this game. Okay, so from what I can see over here, I cannot drop water on this thing. Sadly. But can I instead use the crate? I could try to use this thing, though. I could try to use the wagon to transport the water. I'm guessing that later on you have probably like a pump or something that will allow you to transport the water faster, but... For now, we have to deal with whatever I can. Yeah, you can deliver just water like that. So that's not... Those are the most flat... buckets I have ever saw in my entire life, honestly. Okay, well, this works. We know that thing for sure. So how about I'm gonna try to automate the production a little tiny bit more. I always knew that one day playing Factorio is gonna pay off. So basically, right now, this thing is gonna make me grain. It's actually working. What the hell? Unbelievable. So this thing makes grain. It goes to the grain mill over here, and then the grain mill produces flour, which goes through this thing right to the market. So I just save it myself, like 2 carts and 5 people working using this simple setup. This is brilliant. This is so fucking brilliant. I just need to probably like set up more farms because I don't think one farm can maintain production on this thing. Or can you? Can you? I think you can actually. Holy shit. Or try to just put more fields around. That could also be like the thing. So I'm gonna probably try to do this thing as well because why the hell no, right? We can afford all of this. There you go. Fantastic. Okay, just be sure to supply this thing with water. So I actually need to use one worker. And this one worker is gonna supply this thing with water and it's gonna speed up the growth of the grain, which is gonna be then transported by the thingy to the grain mill, grind it down to flour, and then the flour goes directly to the market without any problem. Okay, so this recording is already long as fuck, and I think this is actually a good moment to cut this episode over here. Let me know what you think. If you want to try the game yourself, I'll leave you link in the description below, as always. And yeah, looking forward for some feedback, and let me know what else would you guys like to see. But for now though, I'm gonna leave this thing as always. And thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed. If you liked the episode, subscribe a lot. I'll see you all in the next video.